What is up, you guys? Today we are about to watch an episode of Death Battle. Now, this is not a new Death Battle. This is a Death Battle that came out quite a while ago, and about a more than a year ago, I think. Yeah, it's the Pokemon versus Digimon Death Battle. Now, I've been meaning to watch this Death Battle for a while now, and I still have not been spoiled. Thank God. Now, on my Urza versus Zoro Death Battle video, I said that I would react to this, and I stand and stick by that. So yeah, here we are now, you guys, finally reacting to this thing that I should have reacted a while ago when. And so yeah, whatever. But better late than never, guys. But yeah, before every Death Battle, I like to give my thoughts and predictions of what might happen first. So it's kind of hard to say with this one because look. I see in the thumbnail a Charizard and a Greymon, so I assume those two are gonna be fighting with each other. But why is it just called Pokemon versus Digimon if it's not gonna be like a whole army against a whole army or something like that? I don't know. I assume that's not gonna be the case. I assume it's just gonna be Agumon and Charmander. But yeah, I don't know. I'm very curious and I want to see it as soon as possible. But I have to get my thoughts out first because that's just the kind of person I am. So yeah, I remember back when I first saw anime, Digimon was like one of my first, very first animes, like right after Pokemon actually. And I remember when Digimon first came out, like just judging by the name alone, I thought it was like a rip off of Pokemon. But when I actually saw it, it was like one of the best shows I've ever watched. I love the adventure, I love all the characters, even the human characters too. And I love like having their journey, like going into the digital world and like a fighting like other monsters and stuff like that. Well, digital monsters obviously, but still. And yeah, and I remember like when the other sequels came out too. They only lasted like 50 episodes each, but like I still love Digimon. Okay, as for Pokemon, I still love Pokemon today. And what I really like about Pokemon is the games. Like when it comes to when it comes to Digimon I love better in the anime, but Pokemon I love better in the games. Like they're about like that's how it is for me. I mean, like Digimon games, like they're okay, and like Pokemon anime, yeah, it's really enjoyable when it can be, unless it's the Black and White series. Oh, let's just pretend that never happened, you guys. I mean, Sun and Moon, and I mean, I'm still kind of like on both sides with that one. I mean, I seen like a little couple of good things right there, but like the animation kind of still bothers me a little bit. See, but yeah, who should I talk about first, Greymon or Charizard? Because those are the two I see from here. I think I'll start with Greymon because I think I have a lot more to talk about with him. Okay, so he'll probably start off as a Agumon, which is like his rookie form. I still remember like the rankings in Digimon. Like, see, it's rookie, and then it's champion, which is Greymon, and then it's Metal Greymon, which is ultimate, and then his mega form, which is the highest form, is War Greymon. And let's see. Like when it comes to looking at this picture alone, I can already see like Greymon already being enough of a match for Charizard, like if you ask me. But I don't know how exactly this battle is gonna play out, and I kind of forgot how strong Digimon really are. But like, I assume they could be like Planet Busters and stuff like that. I that's how the way I remember it as a kid. I have not watched it like I let's see, I watched it like a couple of years ago, but I remember quite the power skill that Digimon really have. But Mega Form Digimon are like fucking monsters, and I think they're way more of a match for Charizard right there. Unless Charizard decided to go Mega Form. Oh, well, that's a funny thing too. I think the creators of Digimon are like has something to do with Mega Evolution in Pokemon. Yeah, so like it's kind of funny that like I wonder if Death Battle will kind of reference that. They're like, oh, you guys ripped us off or stuff like that. Like who's the rip off now, right? But okay, like Agumon obviously cannot touch Charizard, obviously. And so, Greymon, okay, yeah. I could see him doing something. And that's something he could go to Metal Greymon and become like his. It's like a cyborg version of Greymon. He has like a metal claw and he has like torpedoes that shoot out of his chest and stuff, out of his pecs. And, but like, if that's not enough, he goes to war with Greymon. He's smaller, but damn, that guy's powerful. So he could shoot like a fucking, like a coup. Cooler supernova at Charizard, and like I don't know, I assume that's like that technique's like way too powerful like to handle. And you see, okay, when it comes to War Greymon, I remember him doing stuff in the first season because he appeared in two seasons, the first one and the second one. And I remember Greymon against another Mega Form who was Metal Seedramon. Yeah, Metal Seedramon. That's what his name was. And I remember he has like a certain weapons that are capable of handling a Draymond Poke. I almost said Pokemon. Digimon, Draymond Digimon, which are like Dragon type Digimon because that's what Draymond like means. And see Metal Seedramon just happened to be one of those. And like they specialize in killing like dragon type Digimon, and I remember like a certain scene, he like formed into a tornado and he fucking skewered like through Metal Seedramon. That was like the most gruesome thing I've ever seen in Digimon. It was like a kids show too. They did not edit that out either. Like, and Metal Seedramon just died. Okay, like when Digimon die, they turned to data, but that didn't really happen with Seedramon, so that just made the scene all gruesome. But I think earlier in that scene, Metal Seedramon killed Waymon. He like blew a hole through his head too. Like, oh Jesus! Like, it's kind of hard to remember like when you watch like things to watch like as an adult than when you saw them when you were a kid. And I don't think they edited that out too in the English dub either. It's like, oh shit, they had balls back then. Shit, it was not for kids. It was Fox Kids. Fox Kids. Yeah, I was in that generation. But yeah, I remember Metal Seedramon was like one of the four Dark Masters, which was one of the four final villains in the first season of a Digimon. And oh yeah, War Greymon also killed another one of their members too. It was Metal. It was a Draymond too, but I forgot what his name was. I don't remember. Ugh. Metal Dramon? I don't think that was his name. Shit, I don't remember. Okay, whatever his name was, it was yeah, he fucking like I remember he cut him in half, like it like he cuts like right through him, kind of like a swordsman does like in an anime, and then like even though he reverted back into like something below his rookie form, like you see him slowly like start like dr like being drifted apart, and it was like I'm like oh. And Jesus Christ, I still can't believe like that happened though. But I still can't remember his name. Oh my God. But yeah, when it comes to Digimon, I'm kind of just surprised to see here, especially Greymon, because there's like a new series right now that's going on right now called Digimon Try. And like you'd think like Death Battle would wait until like that's over or something, but like that's why I said prior to this battle, but I think Digimon Try is still going, so I guess they didn't want to wait. But yeah, Agumon can still get stronger even if he like after like the information that's like giving here. But I still think Agumon's gonna win this battle. That's who I'm voting for here, folks. And let's see, was there something else I wanted to say regarding the Digimon or Agumon? And let's see. I don't know, but when it comes, I think more Greymon's way more. Oh yeah, the Draymond Destroyers. I wonder like if they will take into consideration of Charizard's Mega Form. I assume they're gonna go Mega Charizard X because that's a more Charizard's battle oriented Mega Form than his Y Form because it's more like close combat like type of deal and stuff like that, and way more fun to look at, I guess you could say. Poor Charizard Y, he never gets any love. But yeah, I assume that's the form they're gonna go for, and Charizard becomes part Dragon type because that's what not what he is usually. He's Dragon, and I know he's Fire and Flying, usually. And like, this thing is not a dragon, but fucking Alolan Exeggutor is a dragon. Like, what the fuck, game? I mean, but I guess they didn't want to have like a starter dragon in the first generation because it'd be way too OP. But I wonder if they'll take into consideration the Draymond Destroyers. Will it work on a Dragon type Pokemon? Because I don't know if the Draymond Destroyers, like, I mean, well, it says Draymond in the name, so I assume it only works on Dragon type Digimon and not Pokemon. But like, I don't know, it's still a dragon, so I assume it'll do something. Okay, so I think we should get on to Charizard now. I don't have too much to say about him, honestly. I mean, yeah, Charizard's pulled some incredible feats in like in his own universe of Pokemon, but not like at the I don't think like not at the level of what War Greymon has done. But and what's it called? I think like there was once a special, like a Mega Evolution special of where he took on like Groudon and Mega Rayquaza and stuff. But I think that was after this death battle, so I don't think like they're gonna so I don't think they can put any information out that like that he took on Mega Rayquaza and stuff like that. And Mega Rayquaza is a beast and stuff, but so well, Charizard didn't even take him out, that's the thing. And if I have to be honest, I was never really too fond of Charizard. Like I know he is really popular among the Pokemon community, but in my opinion he is way too overrated, even more overrated than Greninja. Which is what made me so pissed that Mega Charizard won against a Greninja in the league. Like, oh my god. Oh, why you had to let the most overrated Pokemon win? Hate you, Ryder, so goddamn much. And I know, I think the black and white Ryders, like, had something to do with it. Like, why would you let them? Okay, but, okay, we're past that, we're past that. No, you know what? I don't think I'll ever get over that. I'm not sure I will. But I mean, don't get me wrong, Charizard has a very cool design, like among like the three starters and stuff. Like he has a very cool design. But I don't know, I was never really like too much on the hype train with Charizard. I mean I was like more I was like Venusaur and Blastoise more. Back then I really loved Venusaur, now I love Blastoise more, but like it was never really Charizard. It was never Charizard. I mean I know he's the only one who could fly, but he couldn't even fly in the first games, like Red and Blue, he couldn't use Fly, which is like what? Oh, the funny thing is, like they you could use him to fly on the new Sun and Moon games, but I was kind of disappointed too because whenever I use him for Fly, I mean sure you could see him like you see him like riding on top of him, but like I thought I was gonna like experience riding on him like with Latias and Latios like in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, I thought I was gonna soar across like the islands and stuff. Like I was like, gonna experience flying on Charizard, but no, it's just like using regular fly. It's like, okay. I mean, I guess that's good in some ways, because, but you know, it kind of ruined it for me, honestly. Like, you don't even give me that Game Freak. Like you give me a chance to love Charizard, but you don't even do it. But Oh yeah, Charizard. Okay, he could go into a mega form now, so he becomes like a lot more powerful now. Obviously, like it's what made him like go up against Mega Rayquaza and like ground and stuff like that. But he didn't win though. That's the thing. He won against Ash Greninja, which is quite a feat. I still call bullshit on that fight though, but like I really rather not talk about that. I don't know. There's not a lot I can say about Charizard. Like what has he actually done? He's beaten Articuno before. I mean, this is Ash's Charizard. Who's Charizard? Is this just like a regular Charizard that we're talking about here with like, are they gonna put IVs and EVs into this? I don't know how they're gonna incorporate that stuff into like this battle here because they talked about that stuff in like the Pokemon Battle Royale and in the Pikachu versus Blanka death battle, but I don't know how they're gonna do it here and how that's gonna really affect like against the Digimon too. I mean they did against Blanka, but I don't know like. The way they do research sometimes, I don't know. I really don't know how they come up with it. I mean, I assume they have like a large staff and stuff like that. So, oh yeah. But yeah, you know, maybe this that battle will surprise me. I mean, like, I really want War Greymon to win, and I'm gonna be rooting for him. But you know, who knows? Like, things could go like south really quickly. But yeah, sorry I don't have more to talk about Charizard, you guys. I mean, like, I he's cool, like I'll admit. But like, you know, I've never been like. I never liked him like too much as like other people have. He was been kind of meh to me, but yeah, if you like him, that's cool. I mean, I'll give him credit what credit's due. He has a cool design like for like a first generation Pokemon. Like a lot of the first generation Pokemon have very cool designs, like Rhydon. They're simple, but it's great. Oh yeah, and Rhydon was the first Pokemon too, now that I mention it. And so yeah, I don't know who is more durable here. I mean, that's kind of hard to say because a Pokemon could take like so many hits. Like very strong hits, like Hyper Beams and stuff like that, and they just don't die. And whereas on Digimon, like they could like when they die, they like turn to data and stuff. But yeah, on the off chance that Charizard could deal a strong enough hit to War Greymon and revert him back into Agumon, because that's what happens with Digimon, they revert back to their to like a previous form, like mostly the rookie form if you hit them hard enough. Like well, like if you pretty much defeat them in that form, and if Agumon were to lose, he better transform into fucking data, like not in that bloody shit or anything. But I doubt that would happen. And oh God, please don't let that happen with Agumon. I mean, I could see that happening with Charizard, but not with Agumon. Although that did not happen with Seadrama, Metal Seadramon when War Greymon did that thing. So Now I'm kind of worried. I mean, he did transform to Data after, but he kind of got. He didn't do it right then and there. So yeah, I'm kind of worried now. Shit.
Yeah, I think I said everything I need to say now. So like, oh yeah, like maybe sometime after I'll react to the Guts versus Nightmare Death Battle. Now, I don't want to watch that until I watch Berserk because I've heard great things about Berserk and I want to get to know the character first before actually reacting to a death battle of them. I've heard like how Berserk is regarded as like one of their best favorite animes and stuff like that from like a lot of people, like some on YouTube even, and I would rather like be invested into a character before I see him like in a death battle, you know how it is. Yeah, I don't want to like watch a death battle and not know any who the characters are. I don't even know who Nightmare is at all. But yeah, that's everything now, you guys. So like yeah, enjoy this reaction right here, okay? All right, guys, like before, the headphones are off now. It's just so you could hear the same thing as I'm hearing. So yeah, let's just get this video started now, shall we? All right, and let's get this started in 3, 2, and 1.
This episode of Death Battle is brought to you by Lenovo GameStick.
Oh god, it starts up
Ensure
with
you
an
keep
ad.
watching.
Okay.
Head to lenovogamestick.com and leave a comment to build a video
I
game the
assume
way
the
you
thing they're
want.
that
Just
the thing
click
they're
the link
talking
in the
about
link
is
below to get
monsters
started.
because they
And be
both
sure
end
to
in
keep
Mon
up
and
to
they
date
are
on stage on
monsters.
social media and
Pocket
spread the word.
monsters and digital monsters. All right, let's go.
Since the darkest depths of the human psyche first created monsters,
Yep.
we've dreamed of harnessing their awesome power. Like Red and his Pokemon Charizard, and Tai and his Digimon
I
Agumon.
never, I didn't
Beast
even think
Wiz
of
and Ang
about talking
Broomstick,
about the
and
trainers.
Antar got to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to
Or in
find
the
out who
Digimon
will
case, their
win a
partner.
death battle.
Oh, the animation looks so good. And it is Agumon versus Charizard. I knew it. It was gonna start off that way.
If you're an old man who's wasted his life
And
doing God
they're gonna
knows
use
what,
red?
you
I
may
thought they would
realize
I
that
don't
you've
know if they
always wanted
Yeah,
to
I was thinking
catalog
about are they gonna
every
use
single
red or are
werewolf.
they gonna use
But that would be a lot of
Alon or
work, so you
Ash?
probably would just bribe a kid to do it for you. So began the story of Red, an 11-year-old boy from Pallet Town. Red's mission was to challenge the gym leaders of the Kanto region, defeat the Elite Four to become champion, and of course, capture all 150 currently known Pokemon.
151.
To do this, he needed a partner, a companion, a friend,
If
a
Mewtwo is
Pokemon.
150, then you
For
know about
obvious
Mew.
reasons, he
Why is
chose the
Mew
opposite fire brand.
151?
It wasn't really a tough decision. The thing is, my dad gave me the name Red, hoping that when I grew up, it would help me have the passion and energy of a red-hot fire.
While exploring the world, Red and his
Then
Charmander
what's blue
began to grow
excuse?
and learn.
Or green, as he's
Eventually,
called in
the little red
Japanese.
lizard evolved into the 5'7",
Oh yeah, he's called
200-pound
Green in
flying
Japanese, but he still
Charizard.
picks Squirtle.
Red's Charizard is his go-to Pokemon in battle, and he's taught him a variety of powerful moves. His flamethrower is hot enough to melt boulders, making it over 2100 degrees Fahrenheit. He can throw enemies around with seismic toss, beat the shit out of them with Mega Punch and Mega Kick, trap foes in a vortex of flame with Fire Spin, never miss stars with Swift, and bring the heat even higher with the ultra-powerful Fire Blast.
Charizard didn't use
Being a
Swift.
trained Pokemon, there are dozens of other moves Red may have taught Charizard,
Or did he
including
say that he
Blastoise,
dodged
the
Swift?
most
I don't
powerful
know.
fire attack.
He
Over
doesn't
the
use
course of
Swift.
their adventure beating up
That was
lesser
Mewtwo.
animals, Red and Charizard became more than just trainer and Pokemon. They became friends. And in the Pokemon world, a strong bond between trainer and monster can make crazy
See,
things
now that
happen.
you see
In
using
Red's
Alon's
case, he
image right
unlocked
there.
the power of Mega Evolution.
I guess that's for Mega Evolution.
Mega Charizard X gets a major boost in attack, defense, and special attack, making him a far deadlier Pokemon than before. To add even more power, Mega Charizard X gains the Tough Claws ability, increasing the power of contact moves by 33%. But fighting with a Charizard has its own
I
share
knew
of
it. I called
problems.
it. They were going to
Being
use
a
Charizard
fire and
X.
flying type, a Charizard is weak to rock, electric, and water type attacks. And if the flame on the tip of Charizard's tail goes out, he dies. Man, that seems like the worst thing ever.
Except when
Like,
he
could
goes
you
underwater
imagine
in that
living
one
in
scene,
constant
but
fear that,
whatever.
oh, I don't know, you'd get caught in the rain and die? Fortunately, a Charizard's tail flame burns so hot, not even water can douse it so easily. However, Charizard's battle strategy relies entirely on Red's decision and direction. Without his trainer, he would be as random and unfocused as a
Okay.
wild animal. Luckily, strategy is Red's specialty,
Red is famous for not just his unbreakable faith in his Pokemon, but also his brilliant and sometimes unorthodox strategies in battle.
While they keep saying Red, but they show other clips of other trainers too, like Ash.
Took down the criminal organization Team Rocket and became the regional champion, all in less than a year.
He's good.
So did like 600 kids.
Pokemon on his side. Charizards are proud warriors. They dislike fighting weaker opponents and really enjoy a challenge. Many well-trained Charizards have won tough battles against outlaws. Ash Ketchum's Charizard defeated an Articuno, and both his and Red's claimed victory in one-on-one duels with Blastoises. Blastoise?
I mean, they're like saying that every Charizard is the same, though, when you think about it. I guess they're just showing what Charizard's fully capable of, I guess.
The flame Pokemon's feats. Mega Charizard X has gone toe-to-toe with legendary Pokemon capable of altering the...
So it was after the that evolution special.
Psychic Pokemon known to man.
After becoming the Kanto champion and catching over 150 Pokemon, Red and Charizard wandered the world, always training, always fighting, until eventually they stopped at Mount Silver in Johto. Distancing themselves from the rest of the world for no real reason, Red and Charizard stood atop its peak, waiting for the day a new champion would rise to challenge them.
You know, there's a theory that he might be a ghost, and that's why he doesn't talk. That he died on Mount Silver. Still, like, the most highest level Pokemon trainer, I think, in a game. Like,
fateful summer day.
Oh, they're playing the Japanese song.
Taikamiya, or Yagami Taichi in Japan, went to camp with his friends. It promised to be a summer of fun and youthful adventures. Then a rainbow hole opened up in the sky, shot Tamagotchis at everybody, and sucked them into cyberspace.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, basically. When Tai woke up, he discovered he'd been transported to the digital world, where he met
a bouncing pink blob that can talk.
You don't need to be afraid of me. I'm your friend.
Man, this show is weird.
That's Coromon, a Digimon specifically created to be
Tai. Oh, this brings back such memories.
And to protect Tai from harm, Coromon learned how to Digivolve.
One of my first animes, too.
That's more like it.
Before I even knew what enemy was.
Level Digimon with deadly claws and a fire attack called Pepper Breath.
Pepper Breath.
Together with the other Digidestined.
No way it's called that in Japanese, too.
The digital world, bringing balance to the chaos and destruction caused by several diabolical monsters.
Including an Elvis Presley impersonator who was also a monkey.
Now, let's get some straight, sonny boy.
Oh my god. Edamon, that's there.
Man, how high were they when they wrote this thing?
As their opponents became more...
I mean, his voice was like that in Japanese, though.
...between Tai and Agumon. As their bond grew, so did their power. And Agumon soon learned how to digivolve even further.
First up is his champion form, Greymon.
Digimon, digital monsters, Digimons are the champions. Digimon, digital... That was like the coolest thing in my childhood.
Greymon!
I wonder what he looks underneath that, or can he even take that off?
Pokemon who can still pull up the whole cute and cuddly mascot thing. Greymon is too terrifying story.
Where's that animation from? Is that from a movie I have not seen or something?
Greymon is so strong, he is more than capable of trumping other champion-level opponents in combat, especially with his trademark attack, Nova Blast.
Nova Blast.
Next up is my favorite, Metal Greymon.
Okay, so they are taking other evolutions into this. I thought like they were going to stop at Greymon, judging by the thumbnail.
Of Chrome Digizoid armor, the hardest metal in the digital world. Since the digital world is based on the real world, all real-life metals can exist in it as well, making Chrome Digizoid tougher than the likes of tungsten, steel, and titanium.
And finally, there's Agumon.
What about adamantium?
War Greymon.
Oh, that's not real, though.
No, he's a lot shorter than Metal Greymon for some reason. But it's a small package with a lot of punch.
I love that part. I have the movie still. Do I have it up here? I kind of want to take it down right now, but I want to watch this. Yes, they did the thing!
To his defense, he carries the Brave Shield on his back, which is capable of blocking attacks from other mega level Digimon.
Oh, I forgot about his shield. I forgot it was his shield, too. Aren't those his wings?
Ultimate attack is the Terra Force, where he puts all the energy from the
Yeah, it's Terra Force. I remember Black Greymon's called Terra Destroyer or something like that.
Dragon Ball Z shit right there.
Mm-hmm.
But don't overestimate a Digimon's power. The Agumon line is weak to Earth elemental attacks, and too much damage may exhaust him and force him back to a prior form. Also, while Agumon and his ascending forms can fight and think alone, his power comes directly from Tai. Without their connection, Digievolution would be impossible.
Yeah, but Tai started off as kind of a selfish dick. He even tried to trick Greymon into Digivolving further, which ended in a skeleton.
Oh, that was one time, though.
Well, he never wanted to come off that way, but sometimes Tai was just too courageous for his own good. And for those
Skull Greymon, I forgot about that.
His courage was unprecedented, promoting his strong relationship with Digimon in the first place.
Oh, from the movie.
No, Tai, he's hurt. There's
nothing you can do.
Greymon, wake up, he's coming.
Parrotmon.
Over time, he learned the humility and responsibility necessary to successfully lead the Digidestined against Apoclomon, basically the physical embodiment of the Recycle Bin, and save both the digital and real worlds from being deleted.
Oh, is that what he was?
And with the universe saved, they donned suits to become UN diplomats to the digital world. Drugs, man.
Green digital Nova Flame. No, I've heard that that wasn't even the same Agumon though, from other sources, because like Agumon didn't even remember that. So I think that's like a different Greymon than what he had before.
All right, the combatants are set. Let's end this debate once and for all.
But first,
I could be wrong,
we've got
though.
A mission for you.
No, no.
Hey, do you want to make a video game? Well, then we have a mission for you.
Lenovo hooked up a few former AAA developers with the Lenovo Y series computers. They're making a 3D sci-fi
okay.
game based on your suggestions and feedback.
That's true. Like, if it, yeah, if Charizard's like gonna hit him hard enough, then he'll revert back to his like rookie form or something, and then he'll be in trouble.
To defend your territory.
Leave your comments, questions, and suggestions to influence the direction of the game.
Once you're done, be sure to spread the word on social media using the hashtag
Dargons? No,
let's
dragons,
the game together with dragons.
Dragons.
Or whatever you want.
But right now, it's time for a death battle!
Yeah, get on with it, bruh. Alright.
Ah, there's nothing better than a campfire and a golden, delicious marshmallow.
Kind of sounds like him.
Who's that Pokemon? You killed my marshmallow! Whoa! You can talk? You must be really rare!
Hey, Agumon. I got some...
I choose you! Charizard!
Okay. I don't think that's a good enough reason to battle, though.
Okay.
Okay,
buddy. Go for it!
Pepper breath!
That's not gonna do anything. That Charizard looks skinny, though. Rock smash? Oh! Oh, shit. Come on, Agumon, you got this. Oh, yes. Greymon. Oh, they did their own animation to this, too. That's so cool. He's like, what? In a ball? Dude.
Mega punch!
If you saw it evolve, Why would you throw a Pokemon in? That makes less sense to do so.
Great horns attack!
I think it's just Nova Blast, though, right?
Got him on the run. Turn up the heat.
Jesus.
Fire
blast. Oh. Wait, isn't that five now? Don't you only get five of those? Five PP?
Rock smash! Grima, he's coming!
Yo! Yeah, that's what Tail Whip should be in the Pokemon games. The thing that Pokemon do in the games is tail wagging. That's not Tail Whip.
I guess that's that.
Oh. Mega Evolution.
It's not over yet. I believe in Charizard!
Yo. Oh, he looks so cool here.
Whoa, he digivolved.
No, this is Mega Evolution. Let's go, Mega Charizard. Dragon Claw.
You evolved too, damn it. Digivolve. Metal Greymon. Though, wait, if he did evolve to Metal Greymon, would he be weak to fire?
Agumon, no!
Or is he gonna warp?
Agumon, warp Digivolve, take!
They skipped Metal Greymon! I mean, I still want to see... Okay, let's go. Yo. That is not a Pokemon, you guys.
What? It evolved again?
Yeah! Now you'll see what a real Mega Form can do.
Charizard, take him out.
Yeah, they're both megas in a way. Skewer him.
Dragon Claw.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
You swift.
He didn't have that move. That was new too! Or did he? Now I have to look back. Wait, did he lose his shield? You still haven't done Terror Destroyer. What? Oh! Draymond Destroyer. Oh my god!
Look out!
Oh jeez. Charizard, you okay?
Oh my god. Oh! You're killing a person too, dude! God, dude, you had to kill him too? Yes, he won though.
No, my childhood.
Charizard.
My childhood won.
Mobility and versatility advantage, but the difference in power between the two only grew as the battle went on.
Mm-hmm.
First, when comparing the trainers, Red's bond with Charizard was strong enough to Mega Evolve, but like most Pokemon, their relationship is still one of master and, well,
slave. Come on, you know it's true. I know there's the bond of friendship and whatever, but when Red's through with Charizard, it's back to the tiny spherical prison.
Tai and Agumon, on the other hand, are best friends on equal footing, and Agumon's fighting power comes directly from Tai.
Yeah, these kids were called the Digi-Destined for a reason, and together they had enough power to stop an attack which could have wiped out both the digital and real worlds.
Exactly.
And this is the power Agumon's using to Digivolve.
Charizard's flame could melt boulders, but that's hardly comparable to Chrome Digizord armor.
Hell, Metal Greymon alone is officially documented as possessing the power of a nuclear warhead. And War Greymon has weapons specifically designed to kill dragons.
Honestly, exactly. It all comes down to a huge difference between Pokemon and Digimon itself. The escalation of evolution. Pokemon evolution improves monsters in increments, whereas the gap between Digimon forms is often massive and quite frankly absurd.
That is very, very true.
In the end, Red and Charizard couldn't even hope for as much as a tie.
The winner is the Digimon.
Let's see.
Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm Chad. I play Boomstick.
Alright, you guys. That was so fun to watch. I was wondering if they were going to do the whole Draymond Destroyer thing, like, against Charizard, but I'm kind of glad they did. I mean, like, I did not expect him to kill Red, though. Like, Jesus, that was way too much. they just left two corpses right there. And I kind of wish Ty commented, like, on being like, he didn't turn to data without even Digimon. But, oh, shit. Oh, that was very fun to watch, you guys. I'm so glad that happened. And I'm glad that, once again, the person I am rooting for won again. I wonder if I'm going to watch another one, and this time they'll lose. But, yeah, that's all I really have to say about you guys. So, I will catch you later. And this is just me signing out. Bye.